Hey Cancer, Everlong Mystic here. Today I'm going to get you a see, hear, speak message. We're going to look at what is seen and unseen, what is heard and unheard, what is spoken and unspoken. And there is a chance at a bonus reading for you, Cancer. For those of you that have been here a while, you know what this means. And if you don't know what this means, then stick around and you'll find out. All right. So, what is seen? The Ace of Cups. You know, I'm just getting... This feels like... I don't know, like an accident. Or... Yeah, it feels like an accident, like this bird had an accident and fell into this skull here. It's like you, I don't know, you accidentally saw, like it wasn't on purpose, you didn't mean to see whatever this was. You accidentally saw something. It was just like happen chance. But what was it? What was it? That's weird. That's a huge snake. But you know, there's no fear here. Wow, and it's the back of the Eight of Pentacles. It's like the pentacles are like ghost pentacles. It's like you're showing someone younger how to do something. Okay, so Cancer. So what I'm seeing here is that we have this kind of accidental witnessing of something, and even though it kind of, it could have taken you by surprise, whatever it was, you were not afraid, even though it seemed like it was, I don't know, intimidating or dangerous somehow or something like that, but you were not afraid. And because of that experience, you are teaching, it's almost like you're teaching that skill, the no fear skill to others, like to someone younger or younger generation, or kind of like paving the way, showing them how it's possible to not be afraid. You know, it kind of reminds me of like when a parent goes in and convinces the scared child that there is not a monster under your bed, or you know what I mean? It's weird. So you have an accidental. So what is not seen? What is not seen? So what is not seen is this salamander right in front of his feet. This is sitting, and it's weird because I would expect this guy to be standing, but he's sitting in the face of, like, he's sitting there calm. He's got his wand, right? But he's sitting there calm in the face of the salamander, which is that whole death rebirth. So whatever you've accidentally witnessed here, Cancer, it's like you witnessed like the death of something. You didn't mean to. I mean, you didn't try to witness it. It just kind of, you just saw it happen, right? You saw the end of something happen, and you know, you weren't afraid. But what you didn't see is the rebirth aspect of it. Yeah, it's like you're still, it's like there's a part of you that's still contemplating what, like you're still putting all the pieces together as to what you actually witnessed. And it's the rebirth aspect of it that you didn't see. You didn't see what was going to come of it. You just saw it, whatever that was. Okay, let's look at Herd. What is Herd? Wow, we have the Ten of Cups. That is really awesome. And there is, it's weird, it's like there's, it's not showing rainbows, it's not showing 10 actual cups, it's just showing one cup and this pair of birds here. And these birds, they remind me of like an egret. And egrets and herons, they're very, very patient birds. It's like you're hearing this, it's like this call to patience, like, it's kind of like you hear this voice, it could very well be internal, that's saying like, just be patient, it's coming. Be patient, this happiness, this Ten of Cups, this fulfillment, it's coming. It's not here yet, but it's coming. Yeah, you have a High Priestess here. It's definitely an internal voice. You've got two kings here. You've got the King of Wands, but you also have the King of Pentacles. So, it's kind of like what you're hearing here is like your internal voice is, you know, your inner High Priestess is saying, hey, you know, be patient, it's coming. You happiness is like trickling your way, and you are gonna see it in your, you know, in your physical world, in your 3D life. And this is what you're hearing, and you're hearing this from inside of you. But what you're not hearing. Oh. So what you're not hearing here is that there is, just with these two keys behind the High Priestess, it feels like a choice. I mean, I don't know if it's a red pill, blue pill kind of choice, or what. There is something to do with communication here, because I'm more drawn to this blue and the Mercury symbol here. There's some kind of choice. It's like you're not, there's something that you're not hearing about a choice that's trying to be communicated to you. Just looking at the difference here. You know, this relates back to the fear, Cancer. So it's part of what you're not hearing, but it relates back to the fear. Because he's sitting here in this stone and he's very, very protected. And he's sitting in front of this like bull or whatever this is, and he's just sitting there. Like, this bull can totally go and just charge him, but he's calm. He's calm. He's like, he's not afraid. And that kind of relates back here to where whatever it was that you witnessed that you weren't afraid of, and you taught how to not be afraid, that definitely came from inside you. But what you're not hearing, is just how, just with this pentagram right here, this, it's the ultimate symbol of protection. Like, you don't hear how protected you are. But what's really cool, Cancer, is instinctively, instinctively you knew not to be afraid, and that's really cool. Alright, so let's look at spoken. Five of Swords. This is weird. This Five of Swords, it kind of reminds me of leaving a trail. It's like he's leaving a trail of swords. It's like you are, and the swords, of course, are spoken things. It's like you are leaving, you're leaving a trail of thoughts, a trail of words or something. It could even be written. There's some kind of trail of communication that you are, that you're leaving. And why do people leave trails? Like, so like they can be found in case they're lost or something, I guess. It's like a path. You're creating some kind of path with your communication, Cancer. Ooh, and we have Four of Swords. This is interesting because it feels like this Four of Swords, this guy that's resting, like he's been through a lot. He just went through the Three of Swords and he's taken a breather, right? But I think whatever this thing was, this accidental thing that you witnessed, Cancer, I think it was this person here. It's like you witnessed his heartbreak or whatever happened to him. Whatever just wore him out. And you don't see his rebirth because he's still resting. Ooh, Two of Cups. Aw, that's actually kind of sweet. It's almost like this trail of communication or thought breadcrumbs that you're leaving. It's like you're leaving little morsels for whoever this is to pick up when they're done resting. So that they can mend their heart again. That's pretty cool. So what is unspoken? What is unspoken? Oh my gosh. You know what? What's unspoken here is just the extent of what you saw. It's like you kept a lot of this to yourself, Cancer. And you haven't really talked about just how devastating that scene was that you saw, that you accidentally saw. And that's okay. You know, not everything needs to be spoken. Cancer, you know what is unspoken with you is you dream of this too. You dream of this true love. You dream of this union. You dream of your own heart repair. It's the star right there. That's your dream. It's your wish. You dream of this and you don't talk about it. Yet you still leave breadcrumbs for others to repair their heart. That's sweet of you, Cancer. But you deserve it too, you know? You deserve it too. Alright, Cancer. We're gonna see if you get a bonus message. Reading is over. Okay, Cancer. This is your message. And I thank you for embracing your inner mystic. And I will see you next time. Bye, Cancer.